Hey everybody, Kessler Cascade here. Today I want to show you something cool. Really cool. Ice cold. Okay, bad puns aside, the first time I played Dread, there was something special about coming down that elevator after getting the gravity suit and finding myself back at the start of the game, only everything was frozen solid. Different versions of the same area isn't even that unique a game mechanic, but it just wasn't something I'd ever seen in a Metroid game before. Usually your upgrades only let you traverse the environment better. It's rare for the environment itself to change in such an extreme way. After a couple replays, I learned sequence breaks, and soon found that the quickest way to beat the game didn't even result in the planet freezing at all. But in the back of my mind, I always wondered, what if you could escape that small section of the game you're intended to access while the planet was frozen? What would the rest of ZDR be like? Since it's not just a simple palette swap, I never expected special frozen graphics or anything like that to exist for other zones, but I was very curious if there were any changes or weird effects that you could see elsewhere. A couple people I talked to on the speedrunning Discord had done some exploring using the invincibility glitch back in 1.0, but despite a lot of searching, I found there really wasn't much information out there at all about it. Naturally, once I started learning some of the latest glitches, one of the first things I did was go exploring. It's going to take a few videos to get through all of it, but I want to document what I found for the community and share the weird and wonderful world of Frozen. Let it go. No, not that one. Frozen ZDR. So without further ado, let's kick this thing off. This video is going to focus on Artaria. Artaria? I never know how you're supposed to pronounce these things. It might as well be Atari Land. I don't know. Anyway, despite it being part of the intended route, there's a surprising amount of stuff to see here. This is the loadout I'll be using for the series. It may look a little weird, and it took some glitching through walls and floors and stuff to get, but there is a reason for all of it. The first thing you'll notice is that I'm in Artaria, but nothing is frozen. What gives? False advertising! The reason I'm here is to clear up some of the confusion about what the actual trigger for ZDR getting frozen is. I just need to clip through this door first. It's also possible to get in here using camera lock, but the door clip doesn't need such an elaborate setup. The trigger for the planet freezing isn't actually releasing the X like the game implies, but it's using this elevator. You'd normally enter it from the Berenia side first, but it doesn't matter which direction you take it in. Pay close attention as the scene loads. Let's see that again in slow motion. The water's liquid while the elevator's coming in, then as soon as I get control of Samus, it freezes. The planet is now in the frozen state just by taking this elevator from the wrong side. Since I didn't get gravity suit yet, this big metal thingy is still here. If I use wave beam to shoot out the blobs, you can see some glitchy animation. Can't actually take out the grapple block through all the ice, though. From here I could space jump up and fight the robots if I wanted and explore the rest of Berenia, but instead I'm going to head back to Artaria, to the start of the intended route. Don't worry, there's a lot to see of Berenia, so much that's going to get its own video, so I'll be back. Normally you'd go down and around, through this door, blast the flipper, and then fall down and fight the Chozo Warrior. If you're doing this super early and didn't have Plasma Beam yet, you need to use an aim down flip instead, like this. The reason I'm in here is I want to point out that this is normally a cold room, yet here I am in just Varia suit and not taking any damage. I'm not too surprised they didn't bother to cold in cold damage for the whole planet since you normally have gravity suit in this section, but it's interesting that a room that normally would be cold isn't. This room is where you fight the Red Chozo Warrior, but he's not here since I didn't come in from the hole in the ceiling. Speaking of which, the game really wants you to come in from the hole in the ceiling. Skipping ahead, there isn't much to see along the normal route. If I clip through this door, you can actually get back to the very start of the game and see it looks perfectly normal. Well, almost normal. In this area, there's a weird little spot with an invisible floor. The reason it's here is that this normally gets filled with water to prevent you from backtracking too early, but I skipped the trigger that causes the water to appear. As you'll see throughout the series, water that can dynamically change levels is very inconsistent about how it behaves when frozen. These toxic spitting enemies are fun. They only appear here, and you're supposed to have released the X before freezing ZDR, so they have no script telling them how to die, and just kind of shake back and forth forever. If you skipped a lane, I'm going to back up for a second. For those who don't know, speedrunners have all sorts of weird nicknames for things, and the broken EMMI that teaches you how to kill them is called a lane for reasons, I guess. Anyway, if you skipped a lane and then clip in here, this area will be super glitchy during the freeze, like more glitchy than it usually is. First, there's a cutscene with a disappearing EMMI. Magic. Then I get the Omega Cannon. Or do I? No central unit door, and that message will stay down there more or less permanently. Weird. Oh hey, here's this guy again. Now there are two of them. Kenny Carter had a question about the hot room, so I'm going to pop into this one real quick. As you can see, it looks pretty much normal at first, aside from the door. But if I jump in the lava, something interesting happens. There's no damage. I'm only in Varia's suit, so I should be dying, but I'm not. Samus does still have the underwater physics you get in lava when you don't have gravity suit, but just isn't taking damage from it. I completely missed this the first time I explored frozen ZDR, so big shout out for inspiring me to take a second look. The last stop in this part of Artaria is this little dip in the floor. It's a pretty infamous spot to die for no apparent reason, one that a lot of players learned the early cloak pseudo ran into the hard way. But if I shoot out the blob, we can see this fun animation instead. By the way, that's purely visual. So if I shoot here, you can see there's no collision, and it's still quite deadly. Leaving Artaria after breaking the blob and then coming back would set everything upright and make it solid. As you can see, the broken Elaine CU set a checkpoint, which is really annoying because you have to door clip to get out. I'm just going to load a save and get rid of that and the Omega Cannon tutorial. Now I'm all the way back at the elevator, but instead of going that way again, it's time for something completely different. Note, I didn't actually get Plasma Beam, but I did get Wave Beam to make life easier, since it can also open plasma doors. As I climb up here, you might notice this area does have the special frozen graphic. There's a reason for that, and it's there's actually a developer-intended path to break into the EMMI zone and double back to pick up Screw Attack a little early. If you take that route, you get Screw Attack just before fighting Z57 instead of after. This is the end of that path, and I'm going to take it backwards to get into the EMMI zone. The EMMI zone's interesting for a couple of reasons. It doesn't have custom frozen graphics, but it does have some different enemies than normal, and this blue screen filter that shifts the colors and adds a snow-like effect. But that filter's only applied when you're in areas the developers thought you might be able to access. If I take out this wave beam cover, I can open up a magic portal between worlds. Frozen. Not frozen. Frozen. Not frozen. The other fun thing about this bridge is that while it looks like it's the same screen, the area below it is actually a separate room, but the bridge itself exists in both rooms. So if I sink down, you can see that there's a room transition in midair right below the bridge. You'll notice this whole area is missing the blue filter. Everything below this point you're not supposed to be able to get to while it's frozen. Time for the first EMMI door clip. Frozen EMMI doors are a little different than regular doors or walls. Unlike doors which will push you out, you can use a wall clip angle to get through them, and that can be a lot faster to get than dancing the Samus tornado. But unlike walls, you won't die from going out of bounds if you get too deep, so you can just jump through once you're far enough inside. They're not a huge problem as long as you keep the skew state. This is Zass's ledge drop setup, which makes left-facing wall clip angles pretty easy to get. There's one thing I want to point out about this area here. Normally you'd break a blob right before charge beam, and this passage would be filled with water. But I skipped it and can run around normally. No phantom collision, no out-of-bounds death. Movable water is inconsistent. Also over here, note how this is solid. But break the blob and it will fill up with ice. But look, Samus has water physics over here and can swim in the ice. Trying to roll through the tunnel into the other part's a fatal mistake, though. Back over here again, there's now invisible water. There is an out-of-bounds death zone down there where the ice is, so I'm going to avoid that. Clipping through an EMMI door on the right side is a little more work, since the ledge drop only works for left-facing skew. You can use a tornado to do it, or you can use what I'm doing here, which is DLC's setup. This easy trick is only 3 frame perfect jumps in a row.
3 hours later.
Back in the EMMI zone, I'm going to head back up to the top. There's a frozen EMMI door, but those are hardly an obstacle worth worrying about. Up here is the area where you normally go get grappled. It's pretty normal though. Alright, time to get out of here. On a regular playthrough, the only possible place to go is the Cataris elevator to go fight Z57. Boring. I want to go to Dairon instead. Dairon? Seriously, who even knows how to pronounce these things? Whatever it's called, we'll see a lot more of it in the next video. Dairon. Dairon. Dairy Farm. Daytona? Thanks so much everyone for watching, subscribing, and commenting. Just started this channel and the Crate video got a lot more attention than I expected. I hope you all enjoyed the start of this exploration series and I'm looking forward to showing off more of what happens when Metroid gets really cold.